Write Inbox is an excellent tool for Gmail that allows you to schedule emails to send later, set up email reminders, create recurring emails, and add private notes to emails. First, let me show you how you can schedule your emails to be sent later. Write Inbox integrates with Gmail seamlessly, so you don't need to go through a learning process. Just go to the Compose screen and you will notice an additional button labeled Send Later. So when you need to schedule emails, instead of clicking the Send Now button, you can click the Send Later button. For example, I will write an email as usual, then I will click the Send Later button. As you can see, I have some options here. I can choose the email to be delivered in 1 hour or 2 hours, or maybe even tomorrow morning. These are like shortcuts for you. This time, let me schedule the email for tomorrow morning. So the email is now scheduled. You can see that I am informed by a notification message at the top of the screen, and the scheduled email is now placed in the drafts folder until the delivery time. You can see that the subject line indicates it is scheduled. Later, Write Inbox will automatically deliver this message at the time I chose. What if I want to schedule an email for a specific time? I can go to the Compose screen again and write my message, and then click on the Add a Specific Time option from the Send Later menu. Then a pop-up window will appear where I can choose a date from a drop-down calendar, and I can specify a custom time. Optionally, I can pick a time zone as well. Alternatively, a more practical way would be just typing a date and time or a duration into the input field below. This is actually very handy. For example, you may type in such terms as in 2 hours, 3 days later, or Monday at 8 a.m. There are numerous options here. You may click on the Show Examples and take a look at them to learn more. Let's say I want this one to be delivered automatically on Friday afternoon. Now I can just hit the Schedule button. That's all. This one is also placed in the Drafts folder now. If I want to, I can still go into that folder and edit the message. Or I can just reschedule it, perhaps for tomorrow morning instead. Moreover, please remember that you can easily customize these predefined dates and times in the Send Later drop-down menu to fit your workflow. You may add more options or remove some of them from the shortcuts. Email scheduling is not only for when you are composing a new email. You can schedule your replies to be sent later as well. Also, you can select your preferences using the arrow button. Currently, there are three types of settings. The first one would allow your emails to be delivered only if nobody responds. Plus, you may have the scheduled emails labeled and archived until the delivery time. What if I want to cancel the scheduled email? Just go into your drafts and select the messages you would like to cancel, and then discard it as if it was any other draft message. Alternatively, you may open up the scheduled email from your drafts, where you will be able to see the scheduled date and time. Upon clicking the Send Later button, you may reschedule or cancel the scheduled email. Finally, let me tell you what happens when scheduling occurs. The message will be removed from your drafts folder and then be placed in your sent mail folder. The emails will be delivered automatically. Needless to say, the suffix added to the subject line will be removed automatically prior to the scheduled delivery. Also, you don't need to keep your browser open or computer running. It will be delivered according to the schedule regardless of whether your computer is on or off. Next, let me demonstrate how to set email reminders. If you would like to add reminders in your email conversations, you will just need to click on the Remind Me button and set a reminder before you send the message. First, I compose an email as I normally would, and then I click the Remind Me button before I send the message. You may pick a time for the reminder just like you would with email scheduling. It works the same way, including choosing a specific time and customizing the drop-down menu. Reminders are not only for when you compose a new email either. You may also access this feature when you view a conversation. The same button is placed on the toolbar as well. Again, there are several preferences that you can access using the arrow button. If you would prefer the reminder to be activated only if there is no response to your message, you may enable the first preference on the drop-down menu. Secondly, you have the option to return the conversation to the inbox. For example, if you archive the email after you send it, it will be returned back to the inbox when reminded. When conversations are returned to the inbox, they are placed according to the received date. The third option will ensure the conversation will be placed at the top of the inbox by appending another email to the conversation. The rest of the options are rather self-explanatory. You may choose to add stars or labels to the emails, or mark them as unread when they are reminded. Last, and most preferably, you may have the conversations archived until they are reminded to keep your inbox clean. Also, please note that the preferences you choose are preserved for the next times. Next, let's look into the recurring emails feature. When you need an email delivered on a recurring basis, all you have to do is write a message, as you normally would, then click the recurring button at the bottom of the Compose screen. After that, a pop-up window will appear where you will be able to choose from the options. This is a tremendously powerful tool to ease your periodic tasks. You may select the repeating frequency as daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly. Let's say you need to be reminded late in the afternoon on weekdays for daily reports before you leave the office. Or maybe you need bi-weekly reminders on Fridays at 1 p.m. for team review meetings. Perhaps you need monthly reminders for payments on the first Monday of each month. Even birthdays or anniversaries can fall into this category. You may choose a precise send time for the recurring emails and a start date if you have any preference. The end date or maximum number of occurrences for the recurring emails can also be selected. Additionally, you may take advantage of optional time zone settings when you need to reach out to other parts of the world with recurring emails. Finally, when I hit the Schedule button, I will be informed by a notification message at the top of the screen, and the recurring email is placed in the Drafts folder until the delivery time. You can see that the subject line indicates that it is a recurring email. Also, you can choose the recurring emails labeled accordingly using the arrow button next to the recurring button. Please remember that when you need to modify, cancel, or reschedule an email, you may just go to Drafts. Open up the recurring email and see the details about it below the Compose screen, and clicking on the green recurring button will enable you to make modifications as needed. Lastly, let me show you how you can add private notes to emails. First, let's compose an email as you normally would. Then add recipients and a subject line as always. Once you've finished your email, before sending the email, hit the Add Note button. A new, smaller window will appear with a text box. In the text box, make any notes or comments that you'd like to assign to that email. Please remember that these notes won't be shared with the recipients. Once you've finished making your notes, click the Save Note button. Then you can send your email as you would normally. You'll receive confirmation that your note has been saved. Like the email reminders, private email notes are not only for when you compose a new email. You may also access this feature when you view a conversation. The same button is placed on the toolbar. Feel free to formulate your ideas and comments without revealing to any other recipients. You can maximize your time since all of your thoughts and comments regarding a particular subject or email are right there when you open your inbox. Optionally, you can have those emails with notes labeled using the arrow button next to the Add Note button. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. Thank you for your time.